To continuing with the adjustments, you know, adjustments have double effect. One effect will be in trading or P&L, and the other effect will be in balance sheet. And also you recollect your journal entries for adjustments, that will help you. Or you refer to the table in which we have discussed how to treat an item when it is given in adjustment. So if you see the first item, it is closing stock. So if you refer the table, it states that we should take it in trading account credit side. So I am writing closing stock in trading account on credit side. So closing stock being entered on the credit side of trading account, the amount being 3500. You also know it is an asset, so therefore, and we'll enter it in the balance sheet asset. So closing stock, we are entering on balance sheet asset 3500. Now the next item is with reference to outstanding wages. So it's an adjustment of expenses, and that to outstanding expenses. If you refer the table, outstanding wages becomes personal account. So it is a credit item. So balance sheet liability, you will write outstanding wages, the amount being ₹800, and we should also add it to wages. So wages, because you know the journal entry wages to outstanding wages. So outstanding wages, I'm adding ₹800, making it 2000. Now the next item adjustment is prepaid insurance. Insurance is expense. So prepaid expense given in adjustment, it is an asset, if you remember. So first we'll write it in balance sheet, prepaid insurance, and the amount being prepaid insurance is 100. So the second effect is, you know, we have to deduct it from insurance in P&L, because if you refer the table, it says the same, minus prepaid insurance, the amount being 100, making your expense on insurance for the year 400. That means 100 is next year's. Next, provide depreciation on furniture 10%. So depreciation we need to deduct, so from furniture minus depreciation. So 10% of 2000 is 200, so 1800. The second effect of depreciation is we should show in P&L account because it is expense. So 2 depreciation on furniture, to depreciation on furniture, the amount being 200. Now the next item is with reference to what we say is depreciation on land and building, again 10%. So let us minus here in balance sheet, minus depreciation, that makes it 2000, and ultimately your land and building value coming down to 18,000. Then depreciation is again to be written here in P&L account on debit side because it is an expense. Depreciation on land and building 2000. Now the next adjustment is interest received in advance. Received means always income. So income received in advance, so interest received is nothing but your income received in advance. If we have to treat this as an adjustment, if you see, we need to deduct in P&L account from concerned income. So minus received in advance, minus received in advance 1500 minus 500, so that is 1000 Next, we have to write it on the liability side. So, this is our liability side. We say interest received in advance 500. That's all is your problem. Let us consolidate the things and see where what the gross profit, net profit is. So, from purchases, if I remove, my purchases becomes 9500. Similarly, my sales would become 19500. So, 19500 plus 3500, making it 23000. So, 23000 is credit side total of my trading account. If I minus this, 1018, 38, 38, 12, 8.